एवरीथिंग इज फाइन, एम आई ऑडिबल? ये
यस
कौन
सर।
बार बार कुछ कर रहा है? अंस अब्दुल्ला कौन हो, क्या कर रहे हो ये? सपोज 550 have a Laplace transform, sorry, Fourier transform. See, Laplace transform and Fourier transform are not a very different concept. Basically, all these are interrelated somehow. See what is the relationship you can establish from Fourier transform to Laplace transform, that by some modification. See, what is the Fourier transform of f of t is f of omega. It is defined as integration from minus infinity to plus infinity f of t e to the power minus j omega t dt. Correct? This is the Fourier transform. Now, suppose f of t is e to the power minus 5t ut. It means this function is absolutely integrable. So you can apply here Fourier transform. But suppose the case where so Fourier transform is applicable, but f of t is equal to e to the power 5 t u t. In this case, this is not absolutely integrable. So such type of signal, when function is not absolutely integrable, that type of function, if you wish to convert in frequency domain, you have to put an extra factor so that the function can be absolutely integrable. Now, if this function, suppose f of t is equal to e to the power minus 5t u t. It means it is like this type of function, correct? But f of t is integrable, increasing function when e to the power 5 t u t. So now if you multiply, multiply f of t with another factor e to the power minus sigma t. So what will become? New function e to the power minus sigma t into, suppose let's say this function is gt. Gt will become f of t into e to the power minus sigma t. And of sigma, the value of sigma, you have to put in such that, so that overall function, this will be absolutely integrable. If I put here, now put the value of fp, that is e to the power 5t ut. It will become e to the power minus sigma minus 5 into t u t. Correct? Now, can you comment about the increasing or decreasing, which kind of this function, g t? this function will be either increasing or decreasing, it will depend upon the value of sigma. Correct? If suppose sigma minus 5, this value is positive, then if sigma minus 5 is positive, then GT will be decaying type of function, isn't it? If sigma minus 5, this is negative, then this negative and here one negative, it will become g of t will be increasing type of function. And means it is now absolutely integrable. Here g of t is increasing, it is not absolutely integrable. This is the difference when you put an extra value, that we can say here this sigma, you can say this is decaying factor or damping factor, which damp the value or decrease the value of f of t. Now in this function, if you consider before applying the Fourier transform, if you consider, now we consider sigma minus 5, we consider sigma minus 5 is positive, that is sigma minus 5 is greater than 0 or equal to, if the case is at the boundary. It means sigma should be greater than or equal to 5. If you consider this situation, in that case your g of t will be absolutely integrable and now you can apply Fourier transform. Correct? So new g of t that we considered by the sigma value greater than 5, if you apply now Fourier transform of g of t, it will become Fourier transform of e to the power minus sigma minus 5 into t ut. Now here you apply Fourier transform in this function, it will become integration from minus infinity to plus infinity e to the power minus sigma t e to the power 5 t e to the power minus j omega t u t dt. Correct? This is actual f of t, which was not earlier, it is not absolutely integrable, but when you multiply this f of t with e to the power minus sigma t this term, you can say now the function is absolutely integrable and now we can apply here Fourier transform. It means integration from minus infinity to plus infinity f of t e to the power minus sigma t, this is your actual function gt, in which you can multiply e to the power minus j omega t dt to get actual Fourier transform. Now you can see here this function is now okay to find the Fourier transform. To simplify this only, you can get f of t e to the power minus sigma t e to the power minus j t, both term together, it will become minus g omega t dt integration from minus infinity to plus infinity f of t e to the power minus sigma plus j omega into t dt. Here only sigma plus j omega we can put s, and now power all function will turn into Laplace transform. this is only you can say Laplace transform of f of t. Means any function earlier f of t was not absolutely integrable when you multiply an exponential decaying factor in that term so that it can be convergible or can be absolutely integrable. In that case, now you are free to apply a Fourier transform in that equation, and modifying that, you can again get this term like f of t to the power minus sigma plus j omega t by substituting sigma plus j omega as s. You can say this is now the function of s, and this is your Laplace transform. But don't forget, before in the starting from where we have started, that considering that sigma greater than 2 or equal to 5, and this condition, so that you can easily apply this transformation, whatever we discussed here, this is called region of convergence. Now, if you plot this region of convergence on the graphical form, let put sigma, let put j omega, this is called entire S plane, this is called S plane, which is x axis is a real axis, y axis is imaginary axis, see origin, sigma is greater than 5, it means somewhere on the right side of origin, this is the situation, or this is the region where you can say this type of integration is possible. All the value of sigma greater than 5, you can apply this transformation. See, starting from here, we consider sigma positive means sigma greater than 5. All the value of sigma greater than 5, you are able to apply this type of transformation. For the sigma less than 5, you cannot apply this transformation. So, choosing the value of sigma from the range of 5 to infinity, or plus 5 to infinity, any value, you can get the this transformation. That's why this is called region of convergence, the region where your integration will converge. This region in which Laplace transform will converge. So, in any question, when you are trying to find the Laplace transform, in that case, before applying the Laplace transform formula, you have to check a condition that for what value of sigma you can apply this transformation. How will you check? That is called convergence technique, or the convergence step. You have to verify convergence of Laplace transform. You have to check whether the f of t and e to the power minus sigma t, this value is absolutely integrable. This will be finite quantity. This is also known as ROC, or region of convergence. Do one example and try to understand what I am discussing here. Before proceeding to any example or finding the Laplace transform, first you have to verify whether it is absolutely integrable or not. Whether it is, or you have to find the region of sigma so that you can apply the Laplace transform. So, first example you consider here, f of t is equal to delta t, impulse function. In this case, first you have to check for region of convergence, or you have to apply the function is absolutely integrable or not. For this, what you have to do, you have to do f of t e to the power minus sigma t integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, and find the value of sigma, the range of sigma, so that you can apply in that range Laplace transform. What is the value of this integration? F of t is basically delta t, isn't it, to the power minus sigma t dt. Now here two functions are multiplied, f of t is delta t and another to the power minus sigma t. If you simplify this function, you will get here this t is equal to 0. Put this value and t is equal to 0, e to the power minus sigma t will become 1. And finally, integration of impulse function is constant quantity. It means it is a finite, you know, finite. It is not infinite, it is finite. So here, and it is independent of sigma, finite and independent of sigma. So for any value of sigma, this integration will be finite quantity. This integration is finite for any value of sigma. So you can say the ROC is any value means entire S plane. ROC is entire S plane. In S plane, you plot the value of sigma so that you can get the range of convergence. You will get any value in this range from infinity to plus infinity to minus infinity in this S plane. All value of sigma is acceptable to find the Laplace transform of delta t. This is one part of the question. Any value of sigma is acceptable for finding the Laplace transform. Now come to the Laplace transform. Laplace transform can be obtained e to the power minus st dt multiplied with ft. Here f of t is delta t. So put the value of delta t and e to the power minus st dt. By simplifying this, you will again get 1. This is the Laplace transform value. In the S plane, the value of Laplace transform is frequency domain. In the complex frequency domain, the time domain function delta t, you will get value 1 in complex frequency domain. So Laplace transform of delta t is equal to 1 for ROC is entire S plane. Let's take another example to get the region of convergence for the finite value. Consider f of t as ut. Find Laplace transform and also find the region of convergence. To find the region of convergence, what you have to do? You have to check whether the integration f of t, that is ut, and e to the power minus sigma t, is it convergible or not? Or it is convergible for what value of sigma, what range of sigma? Here, see, this ut will change the limit of integration. It will become from 0 to infinity. एंड e टू द पावर माइनस सिग्मा टी डी टी. दिस इंटीग्रेशन विल बी फाइनाइट फॉर व्हाट वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा यू हैव टू चेक. नाउ कैन यू से व्हाट वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा शुड बी एक्सेप्टेबल फॉर दिस इंटीग्रेशन विल बी कन्वर्जिबल, बिकॉज दिस इंटीग्रेशन cannot give you a finite quantity as in the earlier case. In the earlier example, this integration was a finite quantity. But in this case, you cannot get finite quantity. It will depend upon the value of sigma. If you put the value of sigma at 0, it will give another result. If you put the value of sigma as 1, it will give you another result. You have to check whether all possible value of sigma so that its quantity is convergible. In this case, this is very simple. You can see here, this is a decaying type of function. E to the power minus sigma t, all the value of sigma, if you consider positive value of sigma, for sigma positive, you will get e to the power minus sigma t like this. So it is convergent, it can be integrated absolutely. But for negative value of sigma, e to the power minus sigma, and another due to the negative value of sigma, it will be an increasing type of function. So it will be exponentially increasing. So it will not converge. The integration will not give you finite quantity. If you integrate this function, it will give you infinite quantity. And if you integrate this function, you will get a finite quantity. So you can say it should be acceptable. Here, sigma should be positive, that is acceptable. This integration will be integration, it will be finite when we choose sigma greater than equal to 0 or sigma positive value of sigma. No need to find the value of sigma or no need to find the value of this integration. Keep in mind, the integration का value नहीं खोज रहे हैं और ना ही sigma का value पता कर रहे हैं. I am willing to find the range of sigma so that its integration is acceptable in the finite quantity. All positive value of sigma, this integration will be a finite. And so the range of this sigma is called region of convergence. If you plot as a domain, you will get this region, all the value of positive, the right side of imaginary axis. In this region, Laplace transform is convergible. So it is region of convergence for the Laplace transform. Now find the Laplace transform. Laplace transform will be equal to integration from minus infinity to plus infinity u of t e to the power minus st dt. Now this you have to find. Now again you can see here it will change the limit of integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus st dt. Integrate this, it will become e to the power minus t divided by minus s, and from 0 to infinity it will become 1 by s. So u of t in time domain, its Laplace transform will be 1 by s, and ROC will be sigma greater than 0, except the value of 0, all positive value of sigma you can integrate, and this is your ROC. This is your Laplace transform. Now, do another example. See, if f of t having a Laplace transform f of s, Laplace transform of f of t is f of s, then e to the power minus a t f t, what will be the Laplace transform? Fine. Here given f of t have Laplace transform f of s, it means what is f of s? F of s is basically integration from minus infinity to plus infinity f of t e to the power minus st dt. This expression I am writing, this expression is written in the function of s. You have to find that the Laplace transform of function f of t multiplied with e to the power minus st. Apply the basic rule or basic constant formula that we have given. Integration of this function e to the power minus a t f t with e to the power minus s t p t. So it will become f of t e to the power minus a plus s t d t. Now can you correlate this? Here one function is like this. One function is integration of f t with e to the power minus s t. We are writing this function as f of s. Another expression f t e to the power minus this term multiplied with t. Can you express this function in the form of similarly whatever we have written here, s plus a? Can we write this?
Yes, sir.
So this can be a general formula anywhere. If you have a function f of t and you know the Laplace transform of particular that function, now if you wish to find another function multiplied with e to the power minus a t or plus a t, you can directly substitute s plus a instead of s. Correct? So apply this. No, one thing, what we need change in ROC, that is also important. See, earlier, suppose ROC, in the case f of t, in this case, ROC is, suppose, sigma greater than 0. So in that case, it will become sigma is the real part of s, isn't it? So here also sigma is real part of s. So in this case, sigma plus a will be greater than 0. That will be the change. Like this, you can find the region of convergence as well as Fourier transform for a particular function when multiplied with an exponential increasing or decreasing function. Apply. Formula. If find e to the power minus a t u t, f of t like this function, find Laplace transform. You have two choice. Either you go through the simple method that we discussed, integration of this function e to the power minus a t u t, or minus st dt, or you know the Laplace transform of ft, ut is 1 by s. So Laplace transform of e to the power minus at ut, substitute s with s plus a, it will become directly s plus a. Now you can use this type of formula. Here also you will get the same result. When you solve this integration, you will get the same type of. And here ROC is sigma greater than 0. So here ROC will be sigma plus a
greater than 0.
Do one another example. F of t is equal to u of minus t. Find Laplace transform. This is the time reversal of u of t. You know the Laplace transform of u of t. Here you can apply the time reversal formula also. Either you go through the conventional approach that Laplace transform will be integration of this function with multiplied with u to the power minus a t s t d.
So minus 1 by s?
It will become minus 1 by s. Or directly you can use a formula that f of t have a Laplace transform f of s, so f of minus t it will become minus s. This is for time reversal. You can prove in the previous that we have seen like that only. Proof is not difficult. Also find here region of convergence. ROC batao kya hoga? ROC will be possible.
Less than 0.
ROC?
Sigma less than 0.
Sigma less than 0. Verify के सब लोग solve करें इसको. तो यहाँ पे तुम दिखेगा एक relationship that u of t का Laplace transform क्या था 1 by s और इसका ROC क्या है sigma less than 0 और u of minus t इसका Laplace transform 1 by minus s and ROC sigma less than 0. In this case you can multiply both sides minus 1 minus 1. So see these two example and try to observe something. Two function u of t the Laplace transform 1 by s minus of u of minus t, there also a Laplace transform 1 by s. So you can say Laplace transform is not a unit, it will be same for more than two functions, but their region of convergence is unique. So the region of convergence is important. It will give you the full information about the function. It will required. It is required to represent a function in the form of ROC as well as when you represent it in the form of Laplace transform, ROC is necessary because there is a chance that Laplace transform of more than two functions may be the same. So, if you write Laplace transform including a range of convergence, it will give you the clear picture or full information about the particular function. That's why ROC is also important always. Now do another example. F of t is equal to e to the power minus 2t u t plus e to the power 3t u t. Find Laplace transform. Here two terms are present, exponential one function is exponentially increasing function, other function is decaying function. In both cases, you have to find Laplace transform individually and you can add that to get the overall Laplace transform. Try to simplify and simultaneously you have to find a separate region of convergence for the both terms, and you have to take the common region so that both terms will be convergible in that range. So the first term, Laplace transform of this e to the power minus 2t ut, it will become 1 by s plus 2, because u of t is the Laplace transform 1 by s hai. So here e to the power minus 2 is a multiply q, so directly s will be replaced by s plus 2. And here ROC will be sigma plus 2 greater than 0. In this case, s minus 3, and here ROC will be sigma minus 3 greater than 0. Now, Fourier Laplace transform of these two will be 1 by s plus 2 plus 1 by s plus 1 by s minus 3. But what about ROC? ROC we have to choose common value. One range is sigma plus 2 greater than 0, another range is sigma minus 3 greater than 0. Because the region somewhere, ho sakta hai ye sigma plus 2 is region mein, ye s plus 3 may not converge. Or sigma minus 3 in that range, 1 by sigma s plus 2, maybe this term will not converge. So we have to choose the particular range so that both term will be convergible in that range. And that is called common region. We have to plot the region to see whether both the term is converging in that region or not. This is real part of us, this is imaginary part of us. And when sigma plus 2 greater than 0, it means sigma is greater than minus 2. Sigma minus 2 is the left side of imaginary axis, minus 2, and says increasing greater than this region. When you choose sigma greater than minus 2, that is this region I'm drawing here, in this region, this term will be converged. And another sigma greater than 3. Here sigma minus 3 means sigma greater than 3. Suppose 3 is here. Sigma is 3 right side from the imaginary axis, positive value. And the region of sigma greater than minus 3 is like this. So you can see here, from here to infinity, your 1 by s plus 2, this term will converge. But from here to infinity, 1 by s minus 3 will converge. Can you see here in this diagram, in this region, both terms will converge. What is that region?
The greater than 3. Than
3. Because this region, in this region, the minus 2 say 3 ke beech mein, and there is only one term is converging. But after 3, both terms will be converging. So you have to choose region that is sigma greater than 3 or sigma minus 3 greater than 0. This is your overall region of convergence for this property to find the Laplace transform. So in that way, you have to find region of convergence as well as Laplace transform for the term, more than one term represent, and separately different region of convergence is present. Now find another f of t is equal to e to the power minus 6t ut plus e to the power minus 3t u of t minus e to the power 3t u of minus t minus e to the power 6t u of minus t. Find Laplace transform of more question. F of t is equal to e to the power 4t u t plus e to the power 8t u t plus e to the power minus 4t u of minus t plus e to the power minus 8t u of. Here also find Laplace transform of f. Okay. Do we have more time? Or do we have another class? Hello.
यस सर
क्लास है अभी या और आगे टाइम है तुम लोगों के पास?
यस सर क्लास सर.
ठीक है, ये एग्जांपल्स करो और क्लास में फिर देखते हैं. थैंक यू सर
और इसकी आरोपी तो वाले आरोपी है जो पहला वाला दोस्त है इसकी आरोपी 3